Hey friends, in this video, I'll be giving a walkthrough over the AMS Cloud Service UI. To log into the AMS Cloud Service, first of all, I need to access experience.adobe.com and need to enter the user credential. Once logged in, I'll be landing to Adobe Experience Cloud Home Page. As you can see, there is a header section which takes me directly to the Adobe Experience Cloud homepage and the partner details. I have a section which takes to various Adobe Cloud solutions. You can also see there is a help section wherein I can get all the help related to the cloud related applications. There are various support options available. I can even provide a feedback on this. And all the relevant notifications will be available. There are two sections as you see here. One is the notification and second section is the announcement. Basically, the announcements are related to all the cloud related products and notifications are majorly towards the application access which I am having. And user details gives various options like I can enable the dark theme here and the organization related preference which I can select, and I can log out using this toggle menu. On the bottom section, you can see the greetings and another section called quick access. Under quick access, we have set of cloud enabled options. Let me show more. So as you see here, I have various cloud related applications available. In the next section, you can see your recent activities, what are the sections or modifications you have done on the cloud related applications. And there is a section called For You, wherein different details like release notes, help document, tutorials, etc. are available. The Stay Connected section helps you to be in touch with various Adobe Cloud solutions. You can either watch the summit videos, which are based on demand or recorded and available already. There are different sections like Time to Shine, Step into the Spotlight. There are different a set of promotions are going on, so you can apply for them from this section. All the experience, league related information, the tutorials which are already created, those details are available in this section. You can also give some feedback related to the cloud related products. Next is the footer section, wherein all help, terms of service, privacy policy, language options are available. Let me open up the intelligence section. The Adobe Analytics takes you to the Analytics workspace. Clicking on the target has taken us to the Targets Activity section. We have various options like creating an activity, audience, offers, recommendation, and other administration here. The Adobe Experience Manager section has got the additional sections like Cloud Manager, where you can configure and work with the Cloud Manager related projects, and the Cloud Acceleration Manager, which will help us to assess the cloud related program. And there is a section called Software Distribution, where we can get all the Adobe related softwares, which are specific to the Cloud Manager. Clicking on the launch section has taken us to the various launch configurations like AWP launch, and we can get some additional extensions also here with respect to the Adobe Experience Cloud Builder. The admin console helps us to work with various user related operations like
adding a user, modifying user with the different permissions, working with the user groups, etc. There are different programs which are configured, and you'll be able to modify the user associated with each program in this case. Basically, the reportship mapping helps to enable the mapping of report source with respect to different organizations. As discussed in the previous video, the software distribution enables us to download various Adobe-related softwares from one point of source. The privacy service provides a dashboard for the GDPR-related status report.
In the next video, I'll be giving a walkthrough over the Adobe Experience Manager as a cloud service user interface. Thanks for watching.